wonderful. Yes, I was busy ministering in Texas with all things going on, miracles, signs and wonders. May I believe in miracles?
Amen.
I don't believe in just meeting and say, oh, we were blessed. Glory to Jesus. Physical, visible miracles.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So you are speaking to a woman who believes in miracles.
Amen.
You are speaking to a woman whom God uses in miracles.
Amen.
Whom nothing is impossible.
Yes.
Oh yeah, nothing is impossible.
Yes.
He healed all diseases. Yes. Oh, but they take cancer. What is it?
Nothing.
What is diabetes?
Nothing.
What is chest pain, back pain, whatever? No. Our God. Our God. This great and mighty God,
Amen.
Elohim,
Amen.
Adonai,
Amen.
El Shaddai, Jehovah Rapha,
Amen.
He can do anything. What do you want from the Lord? We're going to handle that. So in the midst of everything he spoke, he said, leave everything, go back home. Prior to that, he said, leave your executive job, a very lucrative job that I went to school for. And I'm like, okay, who does that? I mean, after you have 2 degrees and 2 masters, making it 4, he says, leave the corridors of power. Go to the pulpit. It took a while, but I did it. After when everything was going on very well, he comes in, he interrupts again. He said, go back to Zimbabwe. And when I told people, even, you know, Christians, they say, no, you can't do that. Are you sure you heard from the Lord? Are you sure things in Zimbabwe are horrible? What are you going to do? I am telling you, I obeyed. I picked up my stuff. That's when I met her. I was in the midst of packing because he spoke. Amen.
Amen.
I remember when I landed at a very airport. They said, oh my goodness, are you visiting or are you, your passport says residence? Place of residence, United States of America. I said, I am coming home. They said, oh, there's no cooking oil. Did you buy cooking oil for your family? Oh, we don't have this. Did you bring it? I said, no. I said, why would you do that? I said, you don't understand. Our God is seasons. When the season ends and you disobey, I don't know what will happen. So I did. And I came and I promised her I will come, and here I am.
Amen.
I just launched the ministry. I said, Father, I'm an executive in the financial sector. Can I look for a job and get all these pets and a driver? And he said, no. And I said, yes, Lord. Whatever it takes, I will obey. So someone in here is holding on to something, and you are looking with your eyes of flesh. And say, no, I don't think I had. And anyway, if God speaks to you,
yes.
It's not for discussion.
Yes.
It's not for debating.
Yes.
We are called to obey
yes.
and not to debate.
Yes.
Amen.
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 So some of you are debating. Oh, really? What if? So where am I going to get this? Where am I going to get that? He will provide.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
I lost my ministry and I am going, and I mean business.
Amen.
Oh yeah, so today we are about the Lord's business.
Amen.
Yes. So we're going to talk about Jesus, this man. On the Passover, right? He was crucified on Friday, right? And he was buried on Friday afternoon, according to the Jewish calendar, right? And we have a man called Joseph of Arimathea who said, give me the body of who?
Jesus.
So I can go away?
Bury
it. So this man had a tomb, right? Carved out of a rock, right? And even now, if you go to Jerusalem, if you go to Israel, they will show you this is the tomb, this is the area where Jesus died. I'm going somewhere. Stay with me. Tell your neighbor, stay with her. She's going somewhere. Don't be left behind. Because once she takes off, oh my goodness, you have to catch up. Amen. So, let's see. I want you to see the scriptures because I take it slow so that you understand. I don't want to go boo, you get excited, but you learn nothing. Amen. Let's go to the book of Luke. Book of Luke, chapter number 23. Because this is Saturday night, right?
Yeah.
This is after they buried Jesus.
Yeah.
So we want to take it from there.
Amen.
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 Other preachers who were before me, they spoke about redemption plan. They spoke about the benefits. They spoke about the Holy Spirit. But I'm taking it from what? From Saturday night. Because this is what? Saturday night. So we are moving according to the divine calendar. Amen. Are we on Luke chapter number 23?
Yes.
We are going to read from number verse number 50 to about 54. Amen. This is what I believe in. Jesus spoke to his disciples and the Pharisees and the Jews. He said, the words I speak, they are spirit and they are life. They are what? Spirit and they are life. So when we read the word of God, we are taking in the Holy Ghost, we are taking in life. Amen. So we read together, everybody. I don't care what vision you have to open your mouth. Amen.
Amen.
Are we ready?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, go from verse number what?
50.
Now, I want to show you some truth. of the Word of God. Let's go to the book of Matthew. The book of what? Of Matthew. Chapter number 12. Here we read the scriptures. We open, we see, we talk, we deliberate. Amen. So that you know you have this knowledge and you know that Jesus was doing all these things for you and for me. Amen. Are we there in Matthew chapter number 12? So we are going to read just one verse. Verse number 40. Are we there?
Yes.
If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
If you are not there, say wait for me. Okay. Yeah. Okay, 1, 2, 3, let's read verse number 40. For as soldiers to guard, and this King of Kings left. He went deep down, deep to the belly of the earth, to the heart of the earth, to where the satanic kingdom was. He went there. You know what was happening when they crucified him and he was dead and he was hanging there? They didn't know that, you know, this is the rejection plan for you and me. They were saying, amen. But the Bible says, if they knew, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But they didn't know. So they crucified him. And then when they sealed the tomb and the soldiers were stationed, they were so satisfied. And guess what? They started celebrating. Celebrating where? Down in the heart of the earth. Saying, we have accomplished our mission. This Jesus is no more. But lo and behold. Lo and what?
And behold.
Lo and behold. They were celebrating. Well, we can check it to today. They were like, cheat, shame. From Lucifer to a principality, to a ruler from your father's house, to the powers of Nairobi, Kenya. They were like, cheat. Oh, we did it. Until, in the midst of all. You know, they were celebrating. Lucifer, you did it. Oh, Satan, you did it. Oh, Legion, we did it. We did it. Until they heard the sound. They heard the sound. this Jesus, when he was walking with the disciples, you know, they were talking. He was asking them, what do the people say the Son of Man is? Some say, you are Elijah, one of the prophets. And Peter said, thou art Son of the living God. Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus said, flesh and blood.
Did not reveal that to you.
Yes. But my Father in heaven.
Oh, yes.
Woo! And he said, I will give you the key.
Oh, yes.
Kingdom, before we go to the kingdom of heaven, he said, he was promising them. Maybe they didn't understand. Oh, Jesus says strange things. Like he said, oh, apostle just talks. He said, I'll give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever you bind, meaning whatsoever you don't allow, whatsoever you don't permit, whatsoever you don't like on this earth, heaven will not like it. And whatsoever you lose, meaning whatsoever you shall allow, whatsoever you want, they will do it in heaven. After he gives you what? But he didn't have that key. The disciples didn't ask, they didn't understand. But he knew what he was doing. Amen. So he said, I'll give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. What is a kingdom? A kingdom is a king and his domain, a king and his jurisdiction, a king and his governance. So the keys of the kingdom of heaven, you have it.
Amen.
Oh yeah. He said, I will give you, but he had to go and get it. So let's go back to the belly of the earth. That represents shrines, altars in your village. It represents marital issues. It represents sickness and diseases. You know, I said, this is our disease in our family. All of us have this. We have blood pressure. We have this. This is our family. Not anymore. Because there's the remember, Lucifer was an archangel. Alright. He went and said, end of the keys. The keys I promised my disciples. The disciples are dead. These are yours, your keys and my keys. So he went. Come on, hand over. And he took the keys. And they were just like, what just happened? What just happened here? I mean, the Bible says he went down. There's a scripture that actually he went and then he started preaching. Let's look at the scriptures. You might say, really? Jesus was preaching? Where does it say that Jesus went down? And in the meantime, the Pharisees are thinking, where is Jesus? In the tomb. So people think you are still that boy. That boy who felt 40 years old and you are in your 20s.
I bet you maybe.
That's what they're still thinking. That you still have that disease. That you're still not talking to your dad.
Amen.
They still think you are. She's in there too. So let's look at 1 Peter chapter 3. The book of what? 1 Peter chapter number 3. We want to look at just one verse. Just what?
One
verse from where? 1 Peter, chapter number what? 3. Verse number what? 19. Well, let's look at 18 and 19, right? So you know he actually went down. And then we'll go to the keys. Amen. Amen. Are we there yet?
Yes.
Verse number 19, let's read. For Christ, he just walked in. And this is how you read. Let's do this. 1, 2, 3, go.
For Christ was the
prison.
Amen.
He actually went down there after he died. And after they thought he's where? He was where? He wasn't there, right? They were thinking he was where? In the tomb. They were thinking he was where? Yes, but after he took the keys, and and he started preaching. Where? In the belly of the earth. Preaching to whom? Who was he preaching? To the spirit. So when people die, their bodies are buried, but their spirits go down there. Amen. The spirits that were bound, he started saying, hey, I've just paid the price. I've just redeemed you. They think I'm in the tomb. I've come. Look at my hands. Look at the scars. But now, look at the bunch of keys. Look at the keys. And he said, here, you need to be saved. And he was preaching. He was preaching. Where was the demonic world now? The demon. No, the Bible does not say Lucifer rose or Satan or a principality for Canada or for Southern Africa or withstood him and said, no, you can't do that. No, they were all paralyzed. They were all demolished. They were all useless. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. And he took the keys. The same with us. Don't fear whatever is going on. Don't think too much, too hard. And say, what am I going to do? What are we going to do? No, no, no. Just know that you now have what?
The keys.
He took it. He actually, personally, went down and took the keys. For who? For you and me. What do keys do?
Open.
What door do you want opened? So today we are going to open doors. Using the keys. Conference, it says that in the year that Uzziah died, I saw what? High, not what down, high and lifted up. So he wasn't down, right? He was now up. We saw the Lord high and lifted up and what? Seated on a throne. And the train of his robe filled the temple, and the doorposts were shaken. And the glory of the Lord filled the temple. Hey. Amen. So for you to open with those keys, you cannot open those doors when something is not dead. Something has to die. I said something has to what?
Die.
For you to see who?
The Lord.
The risen and resurrected Lord. She will preach tomorrow. I don't want to take your message. Amen. Mine is just to tell you that he wasn't in the tomb. He was where? In the heart, on the belly of the earth, sorting out stuff for you and for me. Amen.
Amen.
So now what are we going to do with these keys? Do you know in your head you have a lot of keys? That job you want, that business you want, that marriage you want, what do you want for your children? What do you want for your parents? You, because Jesus said, I will give you the what? The keys of an entire kingdom. What is in a kingdom? You tell me, what is in a kingdom?
King and a name.
Everything you want. A kingdom, it has everything you want. And a kingdom with a king, who is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who has everything. For the word says, in him we live.
Yes.
And in him we what?
We move.
And in him we what?
Amen.
Amen. The man who has what? The bunch of what? Of keys. And he gave them to you. Let's look at the bunch of keys. Let's go to Revelation. Let's go to the book of Revelation. If you can't find Revelation, then I think you need the little. Revelation chapter number 3, verse number 7. Revelation chapter number 3, verse number 7. Amen. Revelation chapter number 3, verse number what?
7.
Are we there?
Yes.
Okay. Are we there yet?
Yes.
Okay, let's read about the key. 1, 2, 3, let's read. And the end.
that is holy, he that is true, he that hath the key of David, he that openeth and no man shall
come. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! These are the keys.
Yes.
When God gives you a blessing, no one will take it away.
Amen.
When God opens the door, no one will shut it.
Amen.
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 When he shuts the door, no one will open it.
Oh, yes.
If you say goodbye to that lifestyle, I won't drink anymore.
Yes.
I'm not sleeping around anymore.
Yes.
I'm not telling lies anymore.
Yes.
I am not going to, you know, to do all those big stuff.
Yes.
That's the door that you should watch.
Shut
and throw away the keys.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Are we understanding each other?
Yes.
Are we together?
Yes.
Amen. My message is very short. I'm about to finish and we are going to be opening doors.
Amen.
There's another issue also that Jesus conquered. Amen. Let's look at 1 Corinthians chapter number 15. I am giving you all the scriptures, so when you go home, you look at them and you decree these scriptures in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Are we there? 1 Corinthians chapter number 15. Verse number 55, all the way to 58. Amen.
Amen.
First Corinthians. Are we there?
Yes.
If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
If you are not there, say wait for me. Whom are we waiting for? Okay, 1, 2, 3, let's read. All death, where is your sting? Together a little, what's your money here? What is it called?
Shillings
and all that. But you are a daughter and a son of a king. The Bible says we are the seed of Abraham. Right? We are the what?
The seed of Abraham.
Which means he is our father spiritually. Amen. The Bible says Abraham, who is the father of us all, believed God. But listen to this. If you are the seed of Abraham, he had more than 1,000 camels. Let's just look at camels. 1,000 what? Camels. And he needed a country for his shepherds. How much is one camel now? If we Google, those who want to Google, Google, how much is one camel now in 2019? One camel. Let's Google it. Those who can Google. I told you I preach differently. I'm interactive and we can do an exercise too. Amen. Because I want you to relax. Don't tense up. This is your father's house. Relax. Sit back. Feed from the word of God.
Uh-huh.
Can I have the price, please?
$55,000.
One camel. One camel. Okay, another figure. Let's hear different figures. Come on, change. Be active. Anybody else Googled? The youth, I want to know how good you are at mathematics. 55,000 multiplied by 1,000. Just a comment. How much is that?
Oh, those are the ones that race.
for carrying stuff.
The one that just walks around.
Yes.
80,000.
Multiply by 1,000. Because your father, Abraham, we are just taking a little bit portion of his wealth. He was rich in silver, in gold, in camels, in sheep, and goats, and cattle. We are just taking what? A little bit. How much is that? 80,000, 55,000, multiplied by 1,000. Let me hear the answer.
80,000.
Can you imagine? And how many millions do you have at the bank? And you call yourself a child of God. Oh, a friend. And you are poor. You are an embarrassment to the kingdom of God. A son and a daughter with the keys. We are going to use them today. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Amen. Are we together? Are we together? So after you open with the keys, then you see the glory of God. Because Uzziah will die. What is Uzziah? Who's King Uzziah? I think she gave a briefing on who King Uzziah is. You guys, you remember? Who was that? Who was the king of Israel? King of Judah. When he was 16. He reigned in Judah for 52 years. And he walked the way of his fathers. Until he was proud. And then he went into the temple. He was a king. He was not a priest. He went into the temple and burned incense, contrary to what he was supposed to do. And God struck him with leprosy. From a mighty king to a leprosy, man with leprosy. And then he died from leprosy, from disobedience. And Isaiah was panicking. He was like, okay, so what's going to happen? If we don't have a king, what happened? And God intervened and said, I have come. I am the king myself. I want to reveal myself to you. And that's when Isaiah saw it. In the year that King Uzziah died, when they didn't know what to do because they relied on kings and a priest. So if a king dies, they don't know what to do. Because kings were making decrees and declarations and statutes and commandments, it would be like a country with no president. So like, okay, so what are we going to do? Because these were the priests. Their duty was to burn incense and to advise the kings. And say, okay, who am I going to advise now? What's going to happen? That's when God showed up. So you might be saying, what am I going to do now? What's going to happen to me? This is my second conference. I haven't got my breakthrough yet. What am I going to do? You are going to see the Lord after you open the doors with your keys. Amen, your keys. Just remember, this is the night of the keys. Amen. Let's rise up. Hallelujah. We are going to pray. I am a praying pastor. I am not a... We are going to what? To pray. You are going to demand your rightful place. You are going to take the keys. When I say it's time to receive the keys, you receive the keys. You say, I'm receiving my keys. I'm receiving my keys. And then when I say, let's start opening those doors. Amen. You know what door you want open. Amen. Is it health? What is it? Is it finance? What is it? Then you actually say, I am opening this door. I'm opening my marriage door. I am opening this door. So you need to move away from the aisle and start being active. There are a few things you need to do. Amen. You need to forgive. Yeah. You can't open doors when you are bound in there and say, you don't know what they did to me. I will never forgive them. It's not going to work. Amen. And when you don't know Christ Jesus as your Lord and Savior, it's not going to work. Amen. When you are angry, it's not going to work. You have to let go. So first we deal with what? Giving our life to Christ. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus,
I come to you
because I believe
that Jesus died
on the cross
for me,
and he was buried.
And he was buried.
And he rose again.
And he rose again.
For me.
To give me.
Eternal life.
Eternal life.
Therefore. I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
I give you my life.
I give you my life.
I hand over everything.
I hand over everything.
Soul, spirit, and body. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
You are now my Lord.
You are now my Lord.
And my Savior for real.
And my Savior for real.
Satan.
Satan.
Goodbye.
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 I no longer belong to you.
I no longer belong to you.
I belong to Jesus.
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 The blood of Jesus
has washed me.
Has washed me. When the Lord looks at me,
he is seeing Christ.
He is seeing Christ.
The righteousness of his Son.
The righteousness.
I am forgiven.
I am forgiven.
And I am blessed.
And I am blessed.
I am getting ready.
I am getting ready.
To get my blessings.
To get my
blessings. Using my keys.
Using my keys.
I am the legal right now.
I am
to use right my keys.
To use my
keys. In the name of Jesus. One hand to say, Father,
Father,
I receive those keys.